Good morning, I'm Kiran Raj. Welcome to the online classes on problem solving using C. Today, we'll discuss about some of the problems and programs related to the decision making problem. I'm creating the problem for the collection or the collecting the fees for the certain examination. So I need to have the stdio.h and the stdconio.h. stdio.h will handle the standard input output, and while coming to the conio.h, it will handle the console. But if you are executing in the mobile, you need not have that file. And here in this program, I'll be collecting the fees, and I'll be assuming that if the student or the candidate is of female gender, then she need not pay the fees, and if the candidate is male, then he have to pay the fees. So I'm taking the real time situation in certain examination where the males candidate have to pay the fees and the female candidate need not pay the fees. Okay, so I'll be using the C type also because I want to check whether the student or candidate is female or male. So I'll be starting the main function here, and afterwards, I'll be creating the name variable so that I can store my name and then the sex there. So while coming to the sex, single character is enough for me, so I'm not providing any error there. But while coming to the name, I'm giving the making the character array there, okay, so that it can hold at least 10 characters. And fees, I'm making it as 100, this one, that is of integer type. So I'll be asking for the student name at the beginning. So enter the name of the student. And scanf, I'll be asking the name there. So percentage, yes there, right? Because it is a character array. So I'm storing that in the name. Afterwards, I'll be asking for the sex of the candidate, either it is female or the male. Okay, so he will be entering that, it will be percentage C there. Okay, and it will be stored in sex there. And now I'll be checking whether the candidate is female or the male. So let me initialize the fees also. Let me say that the fees is of 100 rupees. And let me check whether the candidate is female. Okay, so here I'll be converting the sex that is inserted by the user to the uppercase. That is why I used C type dot h. C type dot h has the function where the character can be converted to uppercase or the lowercase by using the two upper and the two lower. So I'll be converting the sex to the uppercase. That is what the user have entered here, right? This sex to the uppercase. Because certain times, certain candidates or the certain individual may input capital letter F and certain people may enter the small letter F, right? In C, and C is the case sensitive language, so it consider capital F different and the small F, small letter F different, right? So I want to make it uniform, so I'm making two upper sex. So even if I enter the small letter F, it will be converted to uppercase F there. Okay, and if I'm entering it in uppercase F, no problem, it will stays in the uppercase F only. So capital F is compared with the capital F, which is easy. So I'll be making print of your now. If the student is a female, then I am updating the fees to be zero. Okay. Now I'm having the printf statement. So I'll be printing the fees of the candidate. Okay. So percentage S is percentage D. So the fees of candidate, the name will be getting printed, and afterwards the fees will get printed. Okay, so comma name and the comma fees. I'll be returning zero. Now if you see here, if the candidate is female, then fees will be zero. Okay, so your the candidate name will be printed and it fees is zero. But let us say that candidate is male, then what will be happening? Then your fees is set to 100 and it will be checking this condition whether M is double equal to F. M is not equal to F, correct? So that time it will be false, so it will not go inside the loop and it will directly print the printf statement. So I'll be executing that. So I have the error here because F is of character and I have to make it character, right? So I'll be making it character now. Okay. So now I'll be executing. So no problem. So I'll be entering my name and mail there. So my fees will be 100. And next I'll be entering another name. You can enter. I'll be entering Lily there. So I'll be entering the sex now, that is female. So I have entered small letter F, see here. But it will be converted to capital letter F and then it will become this one, enter. So here the fees is zero. Okay. Now here I am entering the capital letter F. So again it will be zero only. Okay. Next, let us see about the if else case. While coming to the if else case, you are going to have the two blocks, if block and the else block. If the condition is true, then the if block will get executed, but if the condition is false, then the else block will get executed. So here you are going to have the true statement block and the false statement block. While coming to here, I am creating the program to check the number, which number is greater. So I'll be entering two numbers and I'll be checking whether the first number is greater or the second number is greater here. So I'll be taking two input, that is first and the second, where first represents the first number and the second represents the second number. Okay. So printf. So I'll be entering the two elements there. I want so that I'm printing the statement there. Enter two elements. Afterwards, I'll be having the scanf here. When I'm using the scanf, I can write it in two scanf statement or I can write it in single scanf statement. Okay, that is left to you. For example, if I want to write it in the two scanf statement, then I can do scanf percentage D, then closing of the quotation, comma, and first. Okay, in the second statement I can take the second number, that is again scanf percentage D comma and second. Okay, but let us not do that. So I'll be comparing it. If first is greater than second, then what is the thing? Then you have to print the first number is greater, correct? So I'll be doing that. Okay, first number is greater. If the else, that means if the second number is greater or if the second number is equal to first number, then what I have to do? Then I'll be printing the second number is greater, okay, or equal to first number. then return 0. Okay. Here, if the condition is true, that is first is greater than second, then it will execute this part, and if it executes this part, then it will be directly coming to the return 0. Okay. Now, let us say that first is not greater than second, then it comes and execute the else block. So here I got the error because enter the two numbers is there, and in the mobile when you are trying to enter the input, just have the space or use the make use of space and try to enter the values. If you try to hit enter, then it is giving the problem here. Okay, so that is a problem there. So see here, now I have used the space and then I provided the value, so it is coming proper, right? Answer is proper, right? So again, see here, I just hit at the enter here, so it is giving the problem to me. Okay, so to do that, you have to give the space there, so you can have that. Okay, or what I can do, I can give the slash n here so that it comes to the next line. Okay, so see here, I've given the slash n, so it comes to the next line. See here. Okay. Next we have the nested if. So while coming to the nested if, means one if statement is inside the another if statement. So here one condition is leading to the another condition. In this program I'll be checking the greater of three numbers. So I'll be having first, second and the third. So here I'm entering the three numbers, I'll be entering them, and I'll be taking the three values, percentage D, percentage D, percentage D for first, second and third there. Okay, so how to check? First I have to check here whether the first is greater than second. If the first is greater than second, then I have to check whether the first is greater than third. See here, first is greater than second. Okay, that means what? Let us consider the first is greater, okay, while compared to the second. Then what I have to do in the next step, I have to check whether the first is greater than third. Okay, I have to check whether the first is greater than third. Now if the first is greater than third, then what I can say, then the I can say that first is greater, correct? It should be first number. So I made the mistake there. So it should be first number. Okay. Now, else, that means first is smaller, right? First is smaller. That means it should print the third. See, I made the correction, right? Okay. That means third number is greater, right? So I'll be having that. Third number is greater. So see here, you have the one if statement inside the another if statement, right? Or the if or else, anything. Okay. So here in the else part, that means first is smaller and the second is greater, right? That means if this condition fails, that indicates that first is smaller and second is greater, right? That time I have to check whether the second is greater than third. If the second is greater than third, then I can say that second number is greater, or else I can say that the third number is greater. So I am doing that. So here else the third number is greater. So I'll be entering the values. So 7 is greater. Okay. Better to have the percentage in so that you can come to the next line or the new line every time. Okay. Next. Next, we will be moving on to the if-else-if statement or else-if ladder. So, while coming to the else-if ladder, I am going to use the example of having the student marks and trying to grade him. So, let me say that I have taken the 6 total marks here. So 6 marks I have taken. So I am calculating the total of the 6 marks here. Afterwards, I am calculating the average. Here I made the total as the float here. I am doing the type conversion, explicit type conversion. So that when I make float divided by number, I will be getting the floating point number. So that average can have the floating point number. Okay. So here, I'll be checking if my average is greater than or equal to 8.5, then I'm printing it is distinction. If it is greater than 7.5, then I'm printing it is a first class. And if it is greater than 6 or something like that, I'm making it as second class. Okay. Now, I've taken this grade value by simple assumption, okay. I have not taken the exact value, that is exact value of the grade. I have not taken that. I have just taken the simple assumption value, okay. Now here, so lesser than or greater than or equal to 5, that means third class, then greater than or equal to 3.5, that means just pass, else that means fail, right? Okay, so I'm doing that. So return 0. So I'll be closing them and then I'll be executing here. Here I have the problem, so you can see that. So I'm not closed that, right? Okay, so I'll be entering. So if you see here, again I have made the mistake in calculating the average there. So I'll go back and make the correction, because the calculation of the average here, it should be changed here, okay, because it should be here. Either you can make divided by 100 or you can make it multiply by 100, and you can have instead of 8.5, you can make 85, something like that. Okay, yeah, I'm making it 85, something like that. Okay, so now I'll be getting the proper answer. So yeah, so here also don't try to hit enter. You can have the this one, that is space, you get the proper answer. Okay, so here I'm entering the another name. Don't try to hit enter. You can give the space there. Okay, so 87, 76, 98, 67, 89, 99. So I'll be getting the distinction. You can try with the other values also. Thank you.